Blackstone Audio presents More Than Human by Theodore Sturgeon. Read by Stefan Rudnicki and Harlan Ellison. Part 1. The Fabulous Idiot. The idiot lived in a black and gray world, punctuated by the white lightning of hunger and the flickering of fear. His clothes were old and many-windowed. Here peeped a shinbone, sharp as a cold chisel, and there in the torn coat were ribs like the fingers of a fist. He was tall and flat. His eyes were calm, and his face was dead. Men turned away from him. Women would not look. Children stopped and watched him. It did not seem to matter to the idiot. He expected nothing from any of them. When the white lightning struck, he was fed. He fed himself when he could. He went without when he could. When he could do neither of these things, he was fed by the first person who came face to face with him. The idiot never knew why, and never wondered. He did not beg. He would simply stand and wait. When someone met his eyes, there would be a coin in his hand, a piece of bread, a fruit. He would eat, and his benefactor would hurry away, disturbed, not understanding. Sometimes, nervously, they would speak to him. They would speak about him to each other. The idiot heard the sounds, but they had no meaning for him. He lived inside somewhere, apart, and the little link between word and significance hung broken. His eyes were excellent, and could readily distinguish between a smile and a snarl. But neither could have any impact on a creature so lacking in sympathy, who himself had never laughed and never snarled, and so could not comprehend the feelings of his gay or angry fellows. He had exactly enough fear to keep his bones together and oiled. He was incapable of anticipating anything. The stick that raised, the stone that flew, found him unaware. But at their touch, he would respond. He would escape. He would start to escape at the first blow, and he would keep on trying to escape until the blows ceased. He escaped storms this way, rockfalls, men, dogs, traffic, and hunger. He had no preferences. It happened that where he was, there was more wilderness than town. Since he lived wherever he found himself, he lived more in the forest than anywhere else. They had locked him up 4 times. It had not mattered to him any of the times, nor had it changed him in any way. Once he had been badly beaten by an inmate, and once, even worse, by a guard. In the other 2 places, there had been the hunger. When there was food and he was left to himself, he stayed. When it was time for escape, he escaped. The means to escape were in his outer husk, the inner thing that it carried either did not care or could not command. But when the time came, a guard or a warden would find himself face to face with the idiot, and the idiot's eyes, whose irises seemed on the trembling point of spinning like wheels. The gates would open and the idiot would go, and as always the benefactor would run to do something else, anything else, deeply troubled. He was purely animal, a degrading thing to be among men. But most of the time he was an animal away from men. As an animal in the woods, he moved like an animal. Beautifully. He killed like an animal, without hate and without joy. He ate like an animal, everything edible he could find, and he ate, when he could, only enough and never more. He slept like an animal, well and lightly, faced in the opposite direction from that of a man. For a man going to sleep is about to escape into it, while animals are prepared to escape out of it. He had an animal's maturity, in which the play of kittens and puppies.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.